Oh, yeah. That was all good. Oh, she should not be out on her own. Do you believe that?
I can't believe that.
But she couldn't call you if she really was. They wouldn't let her use the cell phone. Do they slice open a book? I'm wondering.
Ready for another fun day?
I wasn't here.
You're
here
yesterday?
No. How did it go?
You were.
open this fifth one last because it's just got a few in it. But I can't do that because I did the...
Okay.
Whew, I'm warm already. Hi, thanks for coming back. Okay, great. Okay, well, I can't do this because I closed them, so somebody else has to do the change. And it'll happen
yesterday.
I don't
know how
to
do this. One person clip, and then
two
people verify.
Yep, that works. I'll do this to you. Sure. Doesn't matter. She's going to clip, and then, sir, I can get you to help us.
Sure.
Could you just read these tags? There's a number on these?
Sure.
Okay, so this has been 31, 32, 33, 34, and 35 over there. And I don't know if you open, probably don't open them first. Read the tags off to her, and she's going to record the numbers.
Question?
Yeah. Let's see, hold on just a second.
Sure.
Oh, just, I guess you just have to make sure that they're the same. And you'll just print and sign your name to verify that they are.
17988. And then the other side. I guess I can give you the other side at least. Okay, other side is
17995. Good morning, my fellow. Hello. 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 And then when we're done,
Fun.
Yes. Otherwise, if nobody else signs, I'll have to have you sign.
I can sign
as well. Yeah, okay. Never mind. You're good. You're off the hook. Why don't we read these off before you do all the signing so we can just get them open?
Yeah.
Okay.
17985. And 17973.
17951. Okay, and last one's over here.
17958.
17998. Okay, great. So now we can clip them.
Oh,
okay.
So just watch out, because it kind of does, like, fly around sometimes.
Okay.
Yep.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning. So it is 5 minutes after 9, and we're going to start the proceedings. So my name is Michael Pipe. I'm the chair of the Board of Commissioners for Senate County. I'm also the vice chair of the Board of Elections. And we are about to process essentially 3,341 vote by mail ballots and ballots themselves. Our team is currently up front, is currently unboxing them, verifying that the security seals that when they left the Millbank building last night, a little bit after midnight, that they're intact as they should be. They're in jogging them in the envelope and its contents, the ballots out of the way of the building that will occur, and we will then be set to go. So we did have, when we transitioned over to the manual opening, we did have more cuts of ballots or tiers of ballots. Those ballots will still be counted. They're going to be hand counted actually beginning today at 1 p.m. by myself, Commissioner Gershon, and Commissioner Higgins at the election board. So we are actually going to make sure that we are doing the automatic order up front. So we're not going to have you all as extractors opening up with the manual opening. You can, however, use that if the cut didn't occur all the way. You can certainly do that. We're going to make sure that we are essentially providing ballots basically from one. We're going to basically just go down the row to make sure that everybody gets a pack of ballots for the first run. We will again start to open them momentarily. And so essentially then we're going to be shifting that over once they've been extracted. The ballots will be scanned and the empty envelopes will be taken back to the back left corner, to my left in the back, and we'll be good to go. So again, we've got 3,341. It will take us the morning and into the early afternoon with our scanning team as well. So for anybody who hasn't taken the oath yet, we have the President Judge of the Center County Court of Common Pleas, Pamela West, with us today, and we're going to turn it over to her to administer the oath. You will find the oath on your table, and you can essentially take the oath and sign that, and we can have our runners, Sam, Marvie, and Liz, pick them up from you when you're done. So again, good morning, and thank you for being here. Yes, if you took it yesterday, you are good to go. We do have some new folks who are in the room currently. Yeah, thank you. Yes, sir. If you took it yesterday, you're good to go.
Okay, for those of you who haven't taken the oath, would you please stand and raise your right hand? And repeat after me. I, and state your name, having been appointed to serve as an official election worker for the County of Center for the 2020 general election, do solemnly swear or affirm that I will support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, and that I will discharge the duties to which I have been assigned in the vote by mail ballot processing room with integrity and transparency, while abiding by the Pennsylvania Elections Code, and understand all punishable offenses that follow. Okay, thank you. So please sign them. And take them.
Okay, so we are going to be firing up things as we speak. If you have any questions, I will be over here at my desk. We have, and we can point this out for returning folks and also for folks who are here for the first time. You will have two half-folded sheets of paper, yellow and green, and the green will signify that you would need envelopes all over here. So if you can put those up and then take them down when you receive envelopes, that would be helpful to our runners. In addition, if you have an issue, if you have a question, feel free to put the yellow one up, and that will signify that we have somebody come over to answer your question, help you out. Again, err on the side of caution, ask your question, and we'd be happy to get you an answer. Okay? Thank you. Oh, I should say, if you are all absolutely eager to open up your envelopes, but if there is any, oh, yes, thank you. Okay, thank you. I will, yes. If any of you are hungry at this point, if you're doing breakfast over in the Dean's Hall, feel free to take advantage of that. If you'd like to take a quick break now. In addition, lunch will be at 11 until 1. We'll have bag lunches, so we will not be dismissing as groups today. We're just going to, whenever you're hungry, around 11:30, then 12:30, feel free to help yourself to lunch. And then campus, yes, if you have to get up for any reason, any purpose, there is a blue sheet on each of your tables that would say in use. You can just put that in on your workstation, workplace, and we'll be good to go from that standpoint. And for anybody who's staying until, you have a shift until 5 o'clock, so 9 to 1, 1 to 5, you can just use that if you wanted to take lunch. Coming back to that 1 to 5 shift. 1 to 5 will most likely be more of a tear down, clean up. And the event staff here has done a phenomenal job of getting everything set up, but we would just be looking for some help to organize some of our equipment. The three side sneeze guards, things like that. So, again, thank you so much. So, essentially, we'll have about 33 quote unquote batches, 33 batches. And so, it looks like we have about a little bit over 35, let's say 35, 36 extractors. And so there will be several of you in the back who will, once individuals get through the inner envelopes, or I should say removing the inner envelope from the outer envelope, we'll then start giving you all the inner envelopes. So it will take some time for folks in the back to get those ballots. We did not want to open ballots without anybody in the room last night. We also did not want to open any envelopes last night and just have open envelopes here. So it will take a few minutes, but we will get you envelopes.
Thank you.
Just to let you know, one of the things that we're going to do is we're going to open up our issue. It's called it's an issues box. And if you either or both of you wanted to come watch us do that, you're more than welcome to. It's basically a box that we had stored overnight with our ballots that were naked ballots, ballots that had an identifiable mark of the person, party, or candidate preference on the inner envelope that we needed to set aside. What else did we have? We got empty return envelope. So a return envelope that was empty. We had return envelopes that had a secrecy envelope inside, but the secrecy envelope was empty. You can't make it up. So anyway, so we segregated them so that when we do the final count, we know. Well, that's why we didn't have two ballots in here. The naked envelope, I guess. Or not a naked ballot, but a naked envelope. So we're going to open that right now if you'd like to watch it. Yeah. Oh, yeah, I'll get you a copy. Can actually have this. We won't get this. So what we do is the first thing the extractor does is remove the inner envelope from the outer envelope. When they're finished that process, they print signed date. Then the runner, who is, you know, you'll see them literally running, hopefully walking fastly, picks up and takes it to the jogger. Yes, and so the jogger will re-jog the inner envelope. So I don't know if we have any yet that are being...
The ones they run, and then they bring back second. Correct, yeah. Once they have removed the inner envelope, so right there is Candace's. Yep, yeah, if you wanted to. Yeah. So Candace's.
Right, right.
Yep.
That's what we thought.
So those secrecy envelopes then will be picked up by a runner and brought back here to have them jobbed again.
Yeah.
So we get the ballot out of the way as we make the next cut on the envelope opener.
Gotcha.
So they print signed dates so we know who did that batch. Then the attractor removes the ballot from the inner envelope, back bends it and flattens.
Got it.
This front row, I think in probably 15 minutes you'll see that happening. And then when they're done, the runner picks it up and takes it to the scanner. And just feel free to go. Well, whenever you'll see people standing up and operating those machines. But then when the scanners are after finished running it through, they initial time, date and time, and then we have a boxing team where those blue bins are. The ballots when they're finished will go in those bins with this sheet. A report that's generated by the machine, by the scanning machine, and...
It's like after the voting machine, the actual, you know, the same as the regular poll.
Yes. That
they get to the scanner.
Yes. And then that image of the ballot goes onto a USB stick that's then uploaded at the county. And that's how we get the results out. Yep. Yep. So that's... So you can keep this. We will not get to it. Yeah. Yep. Absolutely. Yeah. But yeah, I'm gonna go do the. So if you'd like to join us.
Pardon me, folks. If anyone can recall who did batch number 138, you forgot to sign your orange form. Yep, you can head over to the joggers there. Thanks.
Thank you.
yesterday said congratulations.
Yeah.
And my husband insisted that was wrong.
Oh, no, it is.
Is that a team?
Yeah, it's a local government innovation network.
Okay.
So there's another internet that does, like,
I thought it was a computer.
Yeah, yeah. But there's a local government.
Okay.
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 Yeah. So there's a live stream of it.
And it's on a real channel or just?
Yeah. It's on channel. Well, this is a.
I
Hi, everybody. Just wanted to do a quick check-in. It's a little bit after 10 o'clock. The maximum that people would probably be extracting would be two or three boxes. So we are done jogging, we are done opening up the envelope up front. So there would not be any more boxes after the one you're currently working on. So when you're done, you're all set. What you can then do is we can transition you into doing the, we'll wait until later to do that. We want to have the 1 o'clock folks have the ability to do the verification of the empty envelopes. So we'll have that happen. But just wanted to, so feel free to get refreshments, food, drinks next door. But also, just to let you know, if you could do your best not to look at the results side. So really, when you're opening up the ballot, you don't want to be looking at anything on the ballot face. In terms of votes, write-ins, anything like that, essentially the mission after you remove the folded ballot from the envelope would be to backbend and lay flat. There's no need to look at the ballot. So you shouldn't be flagging any issues in regards of they checked the results instead of filling the bubble, they circled them, they signed the ballot, nothing like that. So just the big worry would be a torn ballot. You want to get those out of the way so it doesn't jam the reader. So that would be it. So again, thank you very much, everybody. Record time, record pace. So many hands make light work. So again, we appreciate you all so much. So just a quick, another quick interruption. So what we're going to do in order there's an appropriate check and balance is the 1 o'clock shift will essentially be doing the checking of the envelopes and emptying of the envelope, or the verification that the envelopes are empty. So we will have our, there are certain teams that are in the back right now working on that, but we'll have them wrap up their batch that they're working on, and then we will begin that again at 1 o'clock. So if you're finished with your ballots and finished with your packet, again, lunch will be available in half an hour. Feel free to take a bag lunch or two with you, and beverages are available until noon. Or I think until much later, actually, than that. But anyway, please help yourself. But yeah, thank you for being a part of the count this morning. We are record time, as always, so thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Thank you. I said before, you may want to put, use your UV sign because you're going to die.
o'clock at home.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I need to take a look. Yeah, one has gotten some something in here.
Really?
That's what 62 say.
Here's your pen.
An incredible amount of money stolen. Thank you.
No, I don't remember her.